It's Wednesday again, and I'm not going to have a big adventure today, so instead I'm going to talk about something that seems to be a little controversial. I'm going to talk about privilege. As I don't really want to turn this into an incredibly long video, I'm not going to detail a lot of the privileges that I experienced, but rest assured there are a bunch. And what I really want to sort of focus on right now is the fact that I don't really understand why it is that people have such an issue with being told that they're privileged. Because for me, obviously I'm willing to admit it, I totally am. I have many privileges, which I said I'm not going to list, but there are a bunch. And I don't know, maybe the initial confusion is that you feel like then that means that you can't complain about anything, or you can't consider your life to be sad at times, or going badly, or whatever, but that's not really the case. At least that's not the way I understand it. For me, admitting that you have privilege just acknowledges that there are some things in your life that you get to experience easier than other people. And that goes for pretty much everybody. And I don't think that's a bad thing, it's just something that needs to be acknowledged, and hopefully by acknowledging it, you are able to maybe help make things better for people who don't have that privilege, or you're at least maybe able to use that privilege to lift up others in some way. So, for example, you know, me publishing the magazine is one of my attempts to try and lift up other people who don't have some of the privileges that I do, and I think it works in some ways, maybe. I like to think so. But obviously in the same sort of, way, by focusing on the magazine right now and not having a full-time job, I'm kind of broke, but I say that with the understanding that my definition of broke, is definitely not the same as other people. I have the privilege of having access to a credit card, I have the privilege of having family and friends that would help me out if I was in a jam. I have the privilege of being in a part of the world where things are a lot cheaper than back home. So for me, when I spent roughly the last month living off of about a dollar a day, it was mainly self-imposed, but it was also rather doable. I'm totally tired of eating beans and rice, but I actually just made more today. But if I wanted to, I could, you know, maybe go back home and get a job. I'm not sure, since some of the folks that I talk to with degrees and more experience than me are struggling and applying at franchise tea shops and, you know, cafes all across the country and still not getting work. So I don't know, maybe I could, maybe I couldn't. I'm not sure, but I do think I have the privilege of having the chance to go back home if I want and leaving the current situation that I'm in. But I'm not going to, because, for one thing, the current situation I'm in has a pool, which is an upside. And so that's kind of going to be where my Wednesday is right now. Obviously, I'm going to work a bit on the magazine to try and find ways to make some money off of it so that I can continue to be self-sustaining in a way and to avoid having to get a different job so that I would then end up not being able to focus on the magazine as much. Because like I said, I kind of see the magazine as my way of using some of the privilege that I have to promote the voices and stories of others who maybe don't have those same privileges. And if that means that I'm eating beans and rice right now, then so be it. That's okay. Although I wouldn't mind having some more Oreos right now, and having the privilege of having a grocery store right next to me would be great. But that's okay. I'll survive. So that's kind of my ramble about privilege. Just kind of, you know, think about it a bit more yourself, why it is that you find it so offensive when someone says that you're privileged, because we all have some degree of privilege, and it doesn't mean that, you know, you can't have a bad day, it doesn't mean that you can't complain, it just means that there are some things that are easier for you than other people, and being aware of that is one of the first steps to working towards changing it, and ideally that's something that we all want to do. So, I hope you're having a good evening, a good day, a good night, and a good morning wherever you are, and I thank you as always for watching, And I will see you again next week.